churn rate. Every SaaS company cares about it. If you still don't do it, please watch the previous part. But this part is going to be pretty much practical. So how are you going to work with churn? There are actually two ways, the reactive one and the proactive one. Well, the proactive actually implies quite many activities, so we're going to speak about it a bit later. And now let's focus on the reactive way to work with churn. Well, reactive way is a situation when you actually saw your users leaving you and then you start taking some actions, like calling them back or sending some emails like, where have you gone? And so on. So churn wants proactive companies and churn needs proactive companies. So let us name a few of the ways you can work with churn proactively. In the previous video, I named a few of the reasons why users may leave you. And one of the reasons is your product is complex. I mean, it is kind of difficult to navigate in it, so it's not user-friendly. So it's time to start the usability testing. Whenever you're working on some feature, whenever you're working on the interface, grab some audience, talk to them, show them the interface, just make sure your interface is pretty much understandable and the users know what to do. So once you have the usability testings passed successfully, A+, it means your product is pretty much user-friendly. So that is not the reason for the churn rate. And we're going to take a look at another reason. That may be lack of value from your product. It is actually worked on during the very first session. So your product team is going to work on the onboarding, because once users get most of the value of your product during the very first session, they are likely to stay with you forever and ever. Well, there is one more way to track the probability of your churn rate. Your product has different features and your users are supposed to be engaged into these features. So they are supposed to use feature A, feature B, feature C, etc. So you can create these certain type of events that are marked as red flags. It means if a certain feature is not used, that is a red flag. If your users stop using certain features, that is also a red flag. So any feature that is a key feature that actually shows the value of your product, and if it is not used, that situation is a red flag for you. So you're going to build a proactive model of working with churn rate. Like, okay, user A is not using feature A. They are likely to churn. So that is the moment when you should start working with these users. You're going to give them a call, probably. You're going to send them an email. You're going to send them some hints in the bubble. If you have a live chat in the admin panel, probably you're also going to show them some pop-up windows. All these communication types can be easily connected with Dashly. By the way, we also have our own red flags. For example, if a user stops using a live chat on their website, that is a red flag for us. Or in case a user visits the admin panel not that often, not that regular compared to the previous period, it is also a red flag for us, because probably the user doesn't feel the value and they do not open the admin panel again. So they simply don't need Dashly. Well, they are likely to churn. Well, also, if a user is exporting all their data out of your product, it is also a red flag, because they're like taking all their stuff, grabbing everything they have out of your product, because the subscription will end and they will close your product and they will not be there and they are not going to be back. They're likely to churn. So, red flags. How are you going to catch them? Well, you can have sort of notification system. Like in Dashly, we actually use Dashly for this. So we have the event tracking system, and once a user does something like exports all the data or they do not use certain feature during some period of time, we get the notification straight into Slack. So once the customer success manager gets the red flag notification, and that is the time for a nice conversation with the user, and it is also the time to give the value to them straight during the conversation. So the churn rate can be worked with in a manual way when you have customer success, for instance, Or you can also create some triggered messages, automated messages in the live chat bubble, in the pop-up window, or you can send some information via email like, hey, we have noticed that you've never used our super cool feature, so why don't you do it right now? And the CTA button. To sum up this conversation about churn rate, I'm going to tell you just few simple words. You can work with it manually. You can work with it locally when you just notice someone is about to leave you. But you can also work with this in a very, very general way, like creating the predictive system and sending certain messages to the users who are likely to leave you somewhere in the future. Well, it is also a great idea to have customer success process in your team, and customer success is very much connected with the upsell. So when you work with the churn rate, you can also retain your customers, but there is also a chance you can upsell them. So churn is definitely a window of opportunity for your company, and you should use it. Curious to know if you people calculate the churn rate or if you actually care of it? Don't forget to put a plus in the comments if you do. See you.